What an intro, what an intro. Nice to have you here, Francisco. I will give this lesson here in or this first speech completely in English. Normally we are, of course, in German language, but it's an international guest. And if you're hearing my voice from the mixing room, that means that is the first time that we have this guest here. And I'm really, really pleased to welcome here Francisco Lima, a wonderful drummer, as you have heard here, from Portugal. I met this guy last year where I did a clinic in Oporto, and what this guy is playing and what this guy, how he can teach, was so amazing that we thought we have to invite him here at Online Lessons. And as I said, more than welcome, Francisco, and I give the word to you. So if you have any questions for all members who are watching, just type in your questions here at the live chat, and I will forward them directly then to Francisco.
Hi, people. I'm Francisco Lima. I'm a Portuguese drummer. And today I'm here on onlinelessons.tv. It's wonderful. It's a pleasure to me. And I'm going to show you some tricks with rudiments and creativity, and how to orchestrate them to be more creative on a drum set. For me, I have like three tricks that I use almost in all of rudiments. Let's begin with a single stroke. I usually look at rudiment, and first I start to replace some notes with a bass drum, with a floor tom. Sometimes I add accents on the rudiment. It's very easy and very tasteful on drums. And sometimes it's more complicated, but it works. I mix rudiments together. And on this kind of thing, or three types of things, I can be more creative, be myself on the drums, exploring my voice, my individual voice on drums. Let's start like a single with a single stroke, like I told you. You have right, left, but if you change the first note of the rudiment, you have some more creative, more orchestrated thing on the drums, like this. You usually have right, left. But if you replace the first note, you have this. Kick, left, right, left. And you can apply this kind of thing into pop music, funk music, whatever you want, and play it. It's an easy one to do on a drum, and you can add some speed with time and study, and start slowly and improve your speed with time. But it's a cool way to improve your orchestration type of thing. If you can replace the second note, and you can, if you replace the second note, you're going to replace the left hand, and you have this. Of course, I can put the toms, I can put the snare, I can put cymbals on there to orchestrate them, and I usually start to see the drum and divide them into a square, and this gives me ideas to orchestrate this kind of rhythmical phrase.
Francisco, there's the first question. Oh. So if you take this concept, so you're replacing one single note with your bass drum, is it important that the sticking stays the same? So for example, you showed it that the second note was replaced by the bass drum, and normally it would be hit by the left hand, so it has to follow by the right hand, right? So yeah. Is this important, or do you care about this? Or
normally, I replace the note. It's the left hand. I replace the with a bass drum. The next note, from the bass drum is the right hand. is a rule that I follow on rudiment, because the rudiment is right, left, right, left. It's for me is important to have a road to follow in to study and to develop these kind of things. If the single stroke is right, left, I usually don't move the combination of the sticking.
Thank you. That totally answers the question. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, and as I'm saying, if you not change the combination of the sticking, and you start to see the drums by a big square, and with a uptown and downtown, you have this kind of thing. And this is a very cool way to improve your feels and your ideas. Orchestrate the single stroke roll is a very easy one, and put down into a groove, and you can lay down with a beautiful feel, with such a powerful with your bass drum, and you have this. Now, I'm gonna use another rudiment, a different rudiment from a single stroke, easy one, of course. It's a single paradiddle. You all know this kind of rudiment, this type of rudiment, and the sticking is right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. If you think of the three ideas that I gave you on the beginning of the lesson, why you don't you replace the first note, the first right hand? And now, if you replace the single paradiddle, the first note with the bass drum, and you start doing a loop of four figures, you have this. And then, as the question that that Florian talks, If you want to have a first variation with only to the right side of the paradiddle, you can do this. You don't alternate your sticking like the single paradiddle normally has. But if you are put your bass drum on the first note and you do the right hand combination, that's my name, the name that I normally do of this type of thing, you have this phrase. If you want, you have the alternating pattern. This is the second variation. Normally, I use the variation number one, the right hand variation, because my kit, my drum set, is always to the right side. It's more easy for me to explore this kind of orchestration. If you start to see this kind of thing like a fill, it's very interesting. It's a beautiful idea to put on a drum set and exploring all the different toms on the different sounds, and your left hand stay on the snare drum, but it could go to the hi-hat and do a left hand on the hi-hat. Very cool. It's a very creative way to explore your drums. And here I see my drums like a big square that I already told you. It's a very easy way to explore this kind of rudiments, the easy ones, and they could create new sounds, new ideas. Your voice, remember.
Yes, thank you. We do have several other questions.
Okay.
The first one is like, I mean, if you take this concept, it's a kind of linear playing, right? And I found out when I was practicing stuff like that, that my timing wasn't that good when I played it for the first time. So how did you improve, or can you give any advice to our students? How do you improve your timing, or that it's perfectly set 16th notes when you play this? How did you practice that?
Okay, how I practice my time on 16 notes figures, it's very easy. I always have to sing. I'm not a good singer, no, I'm not singing, but today I'm not singing at all. But normally I sing there, here on my head. I have always 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4. I don't know if you know how to say drums in Portuguese, but is bateria. If you pick up this word, bateria, 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 you have four bar. It's easy for me. Pick up a word, then you can create your sound with four times, like 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a, and start to say it when you are playing. If you sing along the metronome, along the click, 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2, it's normally is give me lots of support. I can show you. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1. In Portuguese, you can learn the word bateria. It's more easy if you sing when you play. I think it's, for me, it helps. Try to sing very slow. Very, very slow. Because when I start to improve my speed, I normally don't sing always. The thing that I do is listening the word in my head, the voices in my head, and it works for me.
Thank you. That's perfect. Let's go on.
Okay, now we're gonna explore the trick that I told you, the number three, the mixing rudiments. Oh my god, this is a very cool part of the things that I daily basis study with my students, that I normally mix together rudiments. And normally, I respect the sticking of the rudiment. For example, if I pick up one single stroke and then a single paradiddle, you have this. I can show you. One single and a single paradiddle, which starts with your left hand. Oh, I'm sorry. Two single strokes. Two singles. Right, left, and a single paradiddle. I'm sorry, this is another exercise that I'm seeing in my paper. Two single strokes, left, right, left, and then a single paradiddle with your right hand, beginning with your right hand. And the other trick, add accents. I put my accents on the beginning of the phrase, of the orchestration, on the first two notes. Right, left, right, left, left. 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 And this is an orchestration with five notes, five figures. And it's kind of cool, interesting. If you start to see the big square on my drum set, you can apply to the drum set very easy. Start on the drums, start on the snare drum, and open to the big square, like this. Very easy, but if you want to count, I can show you on a pad, practice pad, it's more easy. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a 1. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a 1. Be careful, because the accent moves around the bar. It's a cross rhythm. It's very easy, but challenge. Now I can put my accents on the floor, and the other tom. And now I can alternate with the toms. It's a very cool and useful idea when I start to playing like funk music, pop music. I want to be more creative and start using this on the snare drum and this kind of challenge and orchestrations. I like a lot different drummers, and my teachers give me this phrase, and I start to orchestrate them around the kit using these three tricks that I told you. Replace, add accents, and mixing rudiments. It's very easy. Let's try now with like a feel idea. It's cool, but when you go to apply your cymbal, crash cymbal, whatever, on the first note of the other bar, is with your left, because the orchestration, the final note is with your right hand. Okay, and then we're gonna exploring this orchestration with the other trick, head. I'm going to add my bass drum and one cymbal, and you have this. If you start doing a loop, if you play like a cool beat, it's a very cool idea to develop on drums. If you want to be faster on this kind of thing, remember, respect the accents and the sticking. With the metronome, begin slowly, and begin to study and have some speed to it. It's very, very cool. If you alternate with your cymbals, with your floor toms, you have a best, very good idea, not the best idea, but a good idea to do a solo or something like that. It's a very cool idea. If you have any question, go ahead. I'm here. You can do the questions.
We have some final questions. Oh. We always take the gear questions by the end. But I think we are already coming to an end. you mentioned that you've been playing that you want to play a solo at the end. So we're really looking forward to hear this solo soon. Okay. But before you do this, can you give us a run through your equipment? What are you using? Why are you using what? And how did you tune your drums, etc.?
Okay. Normally, I use this kind of configuration, a 14 snare drum by 6, a bass drum, a 20-inch bass drum. This is a Sonor ProLite, beautiful kit. And then on the floors, on the toms, I have 10 and then 12. First I have a 12 and then the 10.
Is there a reason why you do this? I mean, many drummers do it like Klaus Hessler, Annika Nilles did it, Dom Famularo does it. Why do you do this?
I have several professors that use this kind of combination, including Klaus Hessler. And for me, it's easy because I want something high pitched when I have this kind of movement. It's right away. And then my right cymbal can stay more closely to me and be more comfortably to play. There's another way. If you start to think in a melody, normally you have this. It's that. But if you have this kind of setup, you have this. And asks for more. It's very simple. And I think I can continue with the setup explanation. Yeah. And then, normally I use a big fat snare drum on my left side, live, always. Because when I play like pop music, sometimes the music asks for a big fat snare here, but today I'm only use a snare. And then on my cymbals, I have Sabian cymbals, beautiful Sabian cymbals that I use normally, HHX. I love them all, but when I give clinics or workshops, I try to use cymbals that are defined in sound. Like, for example, the groove adds. It's so defined and so focused. I have power, and I have groovy, and I have focus. And then I have a stage crash, 18, and a 6 splash. It works for me. And then here I have a extreme crash, 18. Like always, it's very focused and defined sound. I can show you. It's like a big explosion. If you combine, it definitely works for me. And then here I have a evolution splash. Is a 10. It's really nice. It works with the with the 6, especially on the this kind of orchestration and study. It's very useful. And then here I have, of course, the evolution HHX Sabian cymbal that normally I use for every purpose. It's so warm and so dark at the same time. Have a beautiful bell. And then have a very cool sound at this part of the cymbal. If you want to crush it, it sounds good too. And here I have a very handful symbol for me. It's a Max Stax Splash on the top, and the Max Stax China on the downside. It's very useful because it's darker, it's crispier and washy. And this gives me some contrast and like black and white of my hi-hat. And sometimes I use it to be more creative. Helps me a lot when I want something different here and I don't want to use my hi-hat. This is the answer that I have on my drum set. And then here my cymbal that always carry with me, it's a Evolution Ozone. It's fantastic. It's like a big explosion but with a China kind of sound. With a crash, is a mix of both. If you want, you can create super effects with it. it's very useful. And then it's like this, my setup, it's very simple and very easy to use. On my sticks, I have Vater sticks, Los Angeles 5-8 stick. It's lighter, but it's powerful at the same time. A very, very good balance on my hands that I use. On drums, this drum have aquarium heads, but it sounds very good. I tested and I used them today at the first time, and very good. I'm very happy with them. And when I tune the drums, when I arrived today at onlinelessons.tv here today, I sit and I test the drums. It's, of course, it's very good tune, because there are always great drummers here. But normally, what I do is start to tune the drums, put the bottom head first, and then the batter head, and then the second hand, the head that I put is the batter head. And this, I don't pitch it too high. But the head that I put in
the reso side head, yes.
Yes, the reso side. It's my normally is pitched higher than the batter head. Okay, the give me a very big sound and more controlled sound. For modern music, I prefer that sound. I tune every tom and floor tom like that. Normally, on the toms, I don't use anything for muffling. On the floor tom, I always use like a moonshell kind of thing, I don't know the name of this, but it's like moonshell, and only one, it's good to give me that power. On the bass drum, I tune it as low as possible, but the 20-inch bass drum give me the low hand that I want, but give me too the balance between attack, power, and low hand. And normally, I put the two heads equal, not too loose, but loose enough to give me low hand. It's easy to do, and very good to use. And I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. This is my setup, thanks to Sonor Drums. Sonor Drums is it's the best. And the cymbals, the Sabian, I have Sabian cymbals with me like 9 years, and always on charge and always keep me surprised. So it's a surprise every time I play with a new model. It's a super innovative company. It's very good. And Vater, thank you very much to these three companies and three brands. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you for your time and all your exercises you showed us today. Hopefully you're not here the last time. And as I said, we would love to hear you play a small solo at the end. I will fade out afterwards. Thank you. Anybody who watches this, check out Francisco Lima at his Facebook profile. And do you have a homepage also?
Yes, I have. This
How is it called?
www.franciscolima.pt. PT from Portuguese, PT.
Perfect. So check this guy out. He's a phenomenal guy, phenomenal player. And We love to hear your solo.
Thank you very much to Online Lessons. It's a pleasure to be here. It's so amazing space, amazing studio. And you guys, thanks for watching. And thank to all of them who supporting this. And thank you very much, Florian. It's a pleasure and an honor to be here.